Christ!
What up, guys? This is Chivo Guides, back here again with another achievement guide. Today we're going to be focusing on Hillbilly Doomsday. This game was published by Sometimes You, and it was developed by Uncle Frost Team. This run-and-gun game is an easy 1000G or Platinum Trophy. I'd say it's going to take about an hour or so to get the full completion. The game also has an Xbox Series X or S stack, so you can play the Xbox One version and then the Series X and S version for an additional 1000G. You heard that right, each version has 1000G, totaling up for 2000G for the stack. Just keep in mind, those are two separate purchases. I'll make sure to leave links down in the description below for you guys, just in case you guys are interested in picking up either of them. Each version is $4.99. So what this comes down to is about a 1 hour completion for $5. Again, has the stack. As you can see, I complete the full game here in about 45 minutes, but that's because I edited out any deaths that I had. Keep in mind that if you die, you're just going to start off at the last room. Now, the achievements or trophies do require that we complete the full game. Each level is going to consist of multiple rooms. If you happen to die, you're just going to start off at the beginning of that room, not necessarily at the beginning of that level, which is cool because the checkpoints are really forgiving in this game. Really, the only downside to dying is the fact that you lose money every time you die. We do need to use this money to purchase some upgrades and get some achievements related to those upgrades. However, there's a nice and easy trick when it comes to spending money on the upgrades. You can actually just purchase an upgrade and then force close the game, load it back up, and you'll have your money again. And then you can just purchase another one of the weapons that have an achievement related to it. There's achievements related to buying the magnet, buying a second pistol, buying a micro SMG, buying a flamethrower, buying a minigun, buying a shotgun, and then getting the RPG. You don't want to purchase the RPG, you could definitely do that, but you end up getting the RPG for free after you defeat one of the bosses later in the game, so I wouldn't necessarily waste your money on that. There are plenty of other weapons or upgrades that you could purchase at the shop, however I don't recommend purchasing those, only purchase the ones that have achievements related to them. Again, you can purchase some upgrades, you can force close it, load it back up, you'll have the achievement but you'll have all of your money back, and then you can purchase something else. And that's the trick for purchasing the different guns. Aside from that, all you gotta do is complete the full game. Now, while we're on that subject, let's talk about tips and tricks for completing it. First and foremost, I recommend just using your shovel. Your shovel is actually one of the best weapons in the game, and you simply just want to keep swinging your shovel through the whole game. If you happen to die, again, you'll just start off at the last room that you're in, and then you'll just try it all over again. But when you respawn, you get 3 lives, so you're gonna have to die 3 times before it'll start you at the beginning of that room again. Most importantly, those 3 lives are enough to get you to the next room. So, really there's no penalty to dying aside from losing some money, but being that we have that easy method for buying things, the money isn't necessarily that important. So, really, you don't need a guide for this full game. I'm giving you guys all the information that you need to go ahead and complete it. Again, just make sure that you use your shovel through the whole game. Just make sure you keep advancing through the levels. Sometimes it'll have you go upward, but for the most part, these levels are all going to go to the right, like with most side-scrolling games. So, just proceed through the levels one by one. Eventually, you'll end up completing the game at about 45 minutes to an hour. After you do that, you'll have the full 1000G or Platinum Trophy. And if you're still motivated enough, you can play it once again for the stack on Series X or S, giving you an additional 1000G. But yeah, that's pretty much all the information that you guys need to know in terms of playing this game. Just use your shovel the whole time. Aside from that, make sure that you purchase all of the weapons or items that have achievements related to them. You have an opportunity to buy stuff at the shop after each level. Again, I know I already mentioned it twice, but I want to make sure you guys understand the easy method for buying things. If you buy something and you unlock the achievement, you can force close the game and your money will come back once you load it up, allowing you to keep your money and maybe buy something else for another achievement. So you don't necessarily need to save up the exact amount needed for all the weapons that you need for achievements. Otherwise, this would make this a bit harder as you would have to save up a lot of money to buy all of those achievement related weapons. And that's pretty much it, guys. Just swing that shovel all the way until the last level and you'll end up unlocking a super easy 1000 gamer score or platinum trophy. Keep in mind the game does have some different boss battles. If you're having trouble with any specific boss battle, you can refer down to the timestamps or chapters below to skip to that boss battle and see how I defeated them. Aside from that, I'm going to go ahead and end the commentary right here as no more commentary is needed. I'll go ahead and leave timestamps for each level just in case you're having trouble with the specific one. But again, I really don't think you guys need the guide moving forward. You guys have gotten all the information that you need to get this full 1000G. As always, I appreciate you guys tuning in. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a comment and don't forget to like and subscribe.
Stage 2, Cemetery. Twist rodeos and ridiculous prizes. Now the coins will go into your pocket by themselves. Already out? See ya!
Thank you.
H3 Down Games. Best rodeos at ridiculous prices. What is good but two is even better. Thank you and goodbye. Stage 4, Abyss. Best rodeos at ridiculous prizes. Best shooting by strong spread. Stage 4, Abyss. Best rodeos at ridiculous prizes. Hot stuff, but only for a short distance. We'll be right back. try next time. Thank you and goodbye. Stage 6, City. Best rodeos at ridiculous prices. Very fast firing. My favorite. Good luck, man, and see you next time.